This past weekend, Judge Aileen Cannon finally got around to, you know, ruling on some of the motions that she's been sitting on for months and months and months. Some of them still from last year, by the way. And of course, it's because she's done nothing about most of these motions over the last 9 months that she decided recently to basically delay Trump's trial indefinitely. There is no trial date anywhere in the near future. Certainly not going to be this year, because she says, I'm just too backed up with all these motions. But as I said, she did get around to, you know, dealing with a couple of them this past weekend. And by golly, wouldn't you know it, she consistently ruled in Donald Trump's favor. One of the rulings she issued was technically against a motion filed by Donald Trump. But even by ruling against it, she's actually still doing him a massive favor. And that particular ruling was Donald Trump's legal team had asked, hey, could you redact some of these witness statements so that they don't get released to the public? And she said, no, I'm not going to do that. Even though I've had to go back and redact the names of the witnesses because I got in trouble for that, I'm not going to redact their statements. And as former federal prosecutor Joyce Vance pointed out, it's actually pretty easy from the statements of the witnesses to figure out who they are. Maybe not for us in the public, but Donald Trump and his legal team can absolutely figure out who these people are, which could then lead to intimidation, bribery, and all sorts of things because there's no gag order in place on Trump and Judge Aileen Cannon's trial. So Donald Trump could know who these people are from these statements that he sees. He could go out and start blasting them on social media. We wouldn't know why, because we wouldn't have access to it, right? But it is what it is. So even though Trump's people filed the motion, her ruling against it actually benefits him, which, by the way, might be why they filed it. Filing a motion with the intent of getting the motion struck down is actually a pretty smart legal strategy and is not something that has not happened in the past. But there was another ruling that's even worse. Let me read you this. Cannon also ruled that where parties disagreed about whether to redact the material because of Trump's claims of attorney-client privilege, she would accept it as privileged, pending reviews. Let me explain to you why that is such a big deal. So basically, if you have Jack Smith go up to her and say, hey, this is not protected by attorney-client privilege, and Trump goes in and says, oh, yes, it is, she's already said her now default position is to go with Trump. First of all, that's insane. You can't just issue a blanket ruling and say, you know what, if you guys disagree, I'm automatically going to go with Donald Trump. That alone should be grounds for dismissal. Like, right off the bat, she should be kicked off the trial for that alone. She's literally telling Jack Smith, if you disagree with him, I'm going to side with him. But, Jack Smith, you do have the opportunity to request a review. And a review would mean a hearing. It would mean more motions. Most importantly, it would mean lots and lots of weeks of delays. She is laying the groundwork to delay this thing even further, folks. That's what that ruling is mostly about. This is what Judge Cannon does. This is who she is. Trump put her on the bench, and by God, she is going to protect him by any means necessary. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.